One of the biggest misconceptions associated with buying a home is that you need a 20% down payment. The other misconception is that you need perfect credit, but that's a whole different video. So today, I'm going to be covering all the different options you have available to you to buy a home with less than 20% down. Let's get moving. My name is Scott Wynn, and I am a licensed mortgage advisor with the Wynn and Egan team at Citywide Home Loans. If you want to buy a home in the next 12 months, then click that subscribe button and together we'll make it happen. There are four major loan programs that exist: VA, USDA, FHA, and conventional. Each of these loan programs has their own different rules and requirements, specifically when it comes to down payment. So let's look at the minimum down payments required for each of these loan programs. How about a hit of that like button? I'd certainly appreciate the feedback, and it lets YouTube know that this information is valuable. Let's start with VA financing. VA financing is an incredible mortgage product. VA helps our service members, veterans, and surviving spouses obtain a home purchase with a down payment with as little as 0%. However, there may be some benefits of putting additional money down. For most people obtaining VA financing, you have to pay what's called a funding fee. Now, the good news is that funding fee can be rolled into the loan itself, so there's no out-of-pocket expense to pay for this funding fee. However, if you put more money down, at 5% it goes down, and at 10% down, it goes even further. So there are some potential benefits of putting more money down when utilizing VA financing, despite the fact that the minimum down payment is just 0%. So let's take a look at the VA funding fee chart. See, before, there used to be different designations depending upon the type of veteran you were, whether it was regular military or reserves and National Guard. Now, everybody pays the same funding fees, but it does depend on the amount of down payment that you're putting down. If you're looking at a zero down payment VA loan, and it's your first time utilizing VA financing, the funding fee is 2.3%. However, if you put 5% down, it drops to 1.65%, and at 10% down to 1.4%. Now that is all for the first time use. If you're utilizing VA for subsequent uses, the funding fee goes up. For 0% down, the fee is 3.6%, but with 5% down, it's 1.65%, and with 10% or more, 1.4%. So now you know, with VA financing, the minimum down payment is 0%, but maybe some advantage of putting 5% or 10% down if you have it available and you qualify for the VA loan. So now let's turn to USDA, or the U.S. Department of Agriculture, and their Rural Development Mortgage Loan Program. The USDA loan offers 0% financing if you qualify under the restrictions for that loan. The USDA Rural Development Loan Program is a 100% financing loan program, meaning no down payment, and it's intended to provide low and moderate income households the opportunity to purchase their own primary residence in eligible rural areas. So there's a couple of things to unpack here about USDA's loan program. First of all, you have to purchase in a geographical restricted area. It has to be a rural area. The best way to determine whether or not a home qualifies as a rural area and therefore USDA financing would be to utilize their lookup tool. By entering the address of the property, you'll be able to quickly identify whether or not it falls within the geographical restrictions allowed per USDA financing. The other thing you have to be aware of is the income limits associated with USDA's Rural Development Loan Program. The maximum income your household can earn is 115% of the area median income. And again, USDA has a great tool where you can enter some information and it will tell you whether or not you'll qualify under the income limits per USDA. So now let's talk about the two most common loan programs out there, FHA and conventional financing. So let's look at FHA first. Generally, the minimum down payment on FHA financing is 3.5%. However, if you have a credit score that is below 580, then the minimum down payment becomes 10%. So if your credit score is between 500 and 579, then you have to put at least 10% down to qualify for FHA financing. Even though FHA does allow for a loan to be done with a credit score below 580, in real world, I don't really see this actually happening. And there's a couple of reasons for that. First is that even though you meet minimum credit score requirements for FHA, and that is at least a 500 credit score, you still have to meet credit requirements. And when we refer to credit requirements, we're talking about things like bankruptcies, foreclosures, collection accounts, late payments, and things like that. there's an excessive amount of these derogatory credit items, those are going to drop your score, which is why generally we'll see a score under 580 requiring a 10% down payment with FHA financing. But if you have too many of these things, FHA won't even approve the loan anyway. And that's the problem we see commonly with credit scores below 580, is that we don't have satisfactory enough credit in order to qualify. But there's a bigger issue. And the bigger issue is that many lenders don't even lend to individuals who have credit scores below 580 anyway. They're called overlays. Each individual bank is allowed to determine who they lend to and set certain credit criteria associated with those rules. Many lenders these days have a minimum credit score of at least 580, and sometimes you'll see them at 600 or even 620. So that makes the point of a 10% down payment FHA loan irrelevant in many situations. So if we look at everything together, FHA's minimum down payment is 3.5%. Last, but certainly not least, is conventional financing. And really, conventional falls into two buckets, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. So let's take a look at Fannie Mae. Fannie Mae has three options that we want to talk about. The first one is Home Ready. Fannie Mae's Home Ready program is a program intended to assist low to moderate income individuals looking to purchase a home and get a down payment of just 3%. Now, the Home Ready program is an income-restricted loan program, meaning you cannot exceed an income limit set by Fannie Mae depending upon the home you're looking at. Similar to USDA financing and their lookup tool, Fannie Mae has their own Home Ready lookup tool. Plug in the property address and it will tell you what the income limit is for that particular home. Generally, what we see is that they are somewhere between 80% to 100% of area median income. But if you're outside of those income limits, you might be wondering what other options exist. Well, Fannie Mae offers a 97% loan-to-value loan program or a 3% down loan option. The only requirement is at least one borrower on the loan must be a first-time homebuyer. And a first-time homebuyer is anybody who has not owned a home for at least the most recent 3 years. So if that's you, then you may be eligible to get a 3% down Fannie Mae conventional loan option. And then, of course, you can turn to the standard Fannie Mae loan program, which allows for a minimum down payment of just 5%. Freddie Mac offers a very similar loan program to Fannie Mae's Home Ready program. It's called Home Possible. Basically, it works exactly the same way. It's a 3% conventional loan with income restrictions. Now, Freddie Mac generally sets these at 80% of area median income. So if you're over the income limits for Freddie Mac's Home Possible loan program, you will either need to turn to Fannie Mae's Home Ready if it happens to have a slightly higher income limits, or the 97% Fannie Mae product if one borrower is at least a first-time homebuyer, or lastly, you'll have to look at the minimum 5% down conventional loan product as the last option with a down payment of less than 20%. However, there are some benefits of putting more money down, similar to how VA provided benefits of putting more money down. The benefit of putting more money down on a conventional loan program is to reduce the cost of monthly mortgage insurance. At 5% down, which is the minimum, you're going to have the highest cost mortgage insurance on a standard conventional loan. At 10% down, it goes down a little bit, and at 15% down, a bit more. At 20% down on a conventional loan, you can avoid mortgage insurance completely, which is why there's that common misconception that you must have at least 20% to put down, because it's such a popular option so that people can avoid mortgage insurance. But now you know, you don't have to have 20% down to make a home purchase. There are clearly many options available between VA, USDA, FHA, and conventional loans, all with different options, giving you the ability to purchase a home with less than 20% down.